Bereshis Shlishi. Adam and now Chava together are in Gan Eden. Adam has named all of the animals by looking into their essence and being able to label them. Now HaKadosh Baruch Hu presents him with the challenge, with the Nachash. At that point, the Yetzer Hara was external. It spoke to him from outside and saying, you want to do this Avera. As we know, Chazal tell us that once Adam ingested the forbidden fruit, the Yetzer Hara forevermore becomes within us. And we have the struggle within ourselves, that struggle for clarity. Chazal have a machlokis, four-way machlokis, what the fruit was. Whether it was an esrog, whether it was figs, grapes, or even wheat. But there is no opinion that says that it was an apple, a Christian myth. So Adam is told, tells Chava, don't touch it. The Nachash now approaches Chava and says, you should eat from the Eitz Hadas. Chava says, we were told not to touch it. And Rashi tells us, they weren't told not to touch it. They were told not to eat it. Adam added a protection and he said, we're not even going to touch it. Question is, isn't that a good thing? Isn't it good to add protections? The answer is yes. But Adam should have told Chava that he was adding a measure of protection. Because now Rashi tells us that the Nachash pushed Chava into the tree and he said, you see, nothing happened. Nothing happened when you touched it. Nothing will happen when you ate it. She ate it, she gave it to Adam. HaKadosh Baruch Hu comes to Adam and Chava immediately upon committing the sin, they were ashamed. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu asks the world famous question, a question that we have to ask ourselves in our lives constantly. Ayeka, where are you? What has happened to you? What has become of you now that you have sinned? Adam made the cardinal mistake. He blamed Chava. Chava blamed the Nachash. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave curses forevermore as a rehabilitation. The Nachash was cursed that it lost its legs and it was it becomes the hated enemy of people. The woman was cursed that she would have Be'etzav Tel Dibanim, that forevermore having children will be a very, very difficult process. And Adam was cursed that B'zeas HaPecha Toch HaLechem, it will be very difficult to make a parnasa the struggles that we have forevermore until the end of time.